There's some common mistakes a lot of people make with their photo editing that makes them look like noobs in Photoshop. Let me show you some of those and how you can avoid them. First one is the sizzle sharpen. Let me show you what I mean. When we choose filter sharpen, I'm going to use unsharp mask. But sometimes you see this. I call this the sizzle because these edges, the halos, are so big it's causing it to kind of pop to white and lose the color and sizzle. That's not a good sharpen. Let me show you how to get around it. Step one, right click on the name, convert to smart object. Now we're going to choose filter sharpen, unsharp mask, and typically you would drop this radius down a little bit lower and keep this amount a little bit lower. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up into the sizzle zone so I can show you how to fix it. See how it starts to sizzle there? Click OK. Now, what we need to do is to the right of unsharp mask, double click. And then we change the blend mode from normal to darken. This will hide the white. And there we go. Number two, clown saturation. So let's go to camera raw filter, and under camera raw filter we have the ability to add saturation. So we want to get some color in the sky. What a lot of people do is they take the saturation slider and they bring it up till they get the color in the sky here, this nice, but look in the middle here, it's too saturated and it's actually clipping in the colors and we're losing detail. And if you want to get these colors out, rather than using saturation, use vibrance. Notice now we get the beautiful colors in the sky, but it's not overly saturated in the middle. How does it work? Well, saturation just makes everything more saturated or less saturated. Vibrance takes the areas that have less saturation and applies more of an adjustment, and the areas that are already saturated, it doesn't adjust them as much. Number three, not enough resolution. Let's drag this image into the other image. Notice it's smaller. But this is what some people do when they composite. Control T or Command T for free transform. Let's drag this out, make it look much bigger. Go across here, apply a layer mask and a gradient. Don't worry, we'll do it again slower in a bit. And we apply, and I create a composite. But notice how we have a resolution mismatch. See how it's softer in this image here? See how it's nice and crisp in the other image? How to avoid that? Go to Bridge, take the lower resolution file, right click, open in Camera Raw. Now, when we're in Camera Raw, right click, choose Enhance, turn on Super Resolution. Click Enhance. Now, if we go and look at the thumbnail, you'll notice a second image has been created. There's our first one. See, it's at 338%, 100% view. Let's click on the new one, the enhanced one. Now it's 196. So it's actually made a higher resolution image. So with that higher resolution image selected, click open. So if you look at the image, now it says enhanced, which means that it's now higher resolution. So let's click and drag into the tab of the image we're going into and release. Now we've combined the two images into one document. Now here's a trick. Take the image that is larger, take it above, to combine them, hit Control T, and now what we're gonna do is take the larger image and we're gonna make that smaller. Just a little bit. So now we're not over enlarging the other image. Let's put it underneath again. Now let's just get rid of the transparency. Image, trim, transparent pixels, okay. And now we mask it. So let's grab that top layer, drag it back, create a layer mask, grab the gradient tool, and at the top here, just choose the black to white gradient, which is the first option. Make sure we've got linear, 100% opacity, drag it across, and now we can combine the images. Let's just trim that again. Now we've got more transparency showing. And now we have matching resolution in the images. So let me know in the comments underneath if any of these were new or if you're guilty of making any of these mistakes. And if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my weekly tutorials. Do me a favor, hit that like button. It helps with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.